Hello everyone. In the previous classes, we discussed just what about C language, how you're performing, what is the use for that, why we invented. Okay, so like we discussed like that, right? So now we will start the our basic topics for the C programmatic. So your today's topic is very, very important. Why? Because you're with this only we are writing the programs. Okay, so here today's topic is the basic structure of C program. So this topic is very, very IMP. Okay, so without this basic structure we cannot understand any program. So always you have to be follow this structure. Okay, once you understand this structure you can write any program in easy way, right? So now we will discuss this basic structure. Okay, so first here you have to be write documentation section. Okay, so this is here I'm writing the basic structure for the C programming. First here documentation section. Okay, once you completed documentation section you can go with the link section. You can go with the link section. Okay, so your linking how it will be done like that. Okay, link section. And next here we have defining section. We have defining section. And next here we have global declaration section. Global declaration section. Global declaration section. And next here we have main function section. And next here we have main function section. And next, after that we have the one opening brace. After that we have the one opening brace and we have declaration part. In this main function section we have declaration part and execution part. Okay, declaration part, and again we have the execution part. Okay, in the main function section, in the main function section we have the declaration part, or else we can call that one is the declaration statements, or else we can call executional statements. Okay, so whatever it may be, declaration part and the execution part. And once you completed that one you can close the our main function section. After that you can write sub program section. After that you can write sub program section. Okay, sub program section. And in that again you have to be open the one opening brace. In that you have to be write functions. Okay, function one, here I'm taking the function one, function two, and after so on, any functions you can take, how many you need you can use that functions only here. Okay, here I'm taking the function n. Okay, here I'm taking the up to n functions, up to n functions I'm taking. So this is the our basic structure for the C programmatic. Okay, so see here carefully, we have documentation section, link section, defining section, global declaration section, main function section, and in that main function section we again we have the declaration part, or else we can call that one declaration statements, and we have execution part, so we can call that is like execution statements. And once you can close that main function section, again we have the sub program section. So not only main program, if you need to be write the more than that, means here you can use the sub programs. This sub program is not in the all the programs, it may be in the some programs only. Okay, in that we have functions. Okay, so this function is starting with the 1 and ending with the n. So suppose you are taking the number n value is 10, means you are up to 10 functions you can mention in this. Whatever it may be, any functions you can place into this, right? Okay, so this documentation section. Okay, so here this is the our documentation section. We can call this is this is optional. This documentation section is the optional section, right? This documentation section is the optional section. See here, I will draw this one to one box. You will understand. Okay, so otherwise you will not understand this one. Whether it is having the optional or mandatory, like this you cannot understand. So here I will give the box for this. Okay, documentation section is the optional. Okay, and your linking and defining section, linking and defining section, we can call that to header file section. We can call that one is the header file section. So your link section, defining section, we can call. Okay, so don't forget here what we are calling header section. Header section, this is the mandatory. This section is the mandatory. Mandatory means here definitely have to be mentioned when you are writing the programs. Without the including this, so your program will not run anything. Okay, so here this is the header section. Link section and defining section is the header section. So this is the mandatory section. And next we have the global declaration section. Okay, here we have the next one, global declaration section. Okay, so in this normally we will write like what we have the data types and what we have the variables, like this. Okay, so this is also mandatory. Okay, so this is also mandatory. And next here we have the main function section. Next here we have the main function section. So this main function section is the very, very important. Without that, here nothing is there in the programming. Okay, so means here definitely it is mandatory. Without this, here you can't perform any programmatic. Okay, so here this is the main program. Okay, we can call this one is the main program section. We can call this one main program section. At last we have the sub program section, right? We can call that to user defined function section. Okay, so if the user is required for that, your user can mention that one, user defined function section. If user need, they can write anything. So if not, yeah, they are not writing. So this is also one optional. Okay, see here, documentation section is the optional section, and here we have the link and defining sections. Those are the header files, headers. Okay, so this is mandatory. Okay, here link section and defining section, these two are the mandatory. And the when you are writing the programs, here this is header section. Okay, we can call that is the header sections. Global declaration section is also mandatory, in that we are using the our data types with the variables. In the main function, without the main function, we cannot process any programmatic, not only C language. You can go with the Java programmatic or C++, Python, .NET, anything. So without the main function, we cannot start anything, right? That is definitely mandatory to write the programs. So this is our main program section. Okay, whatever you are declaring, whatever you need to be execute, that can be declared in the our main function, right? And we have the sub program section. So if it is need, in the time only we are using that one. So in this we are placing the our functions format. So this is the user defined function section. Whatever user need, that is only here we are performing. This is also optional, but when you are writing the functions, you're definitely we are using this one. So not in all cases we are using the sub program sections. In some cases only, some situations only, we are using this one, right? This is the our basic structure. So now we need to be discuss what is documentation section, what is link. Like this here we will discuss line to line. Okay, so first go with the documentation section. Okay, first here we have documentation section. Okay, what is documentation section? What is the use? How you are performing these two programmatic? Okay, this is the just basic structure only. So by that you are writing these statements into the our programmatic. Okay, let's see here. Okay, we have the documentation first. In this section, in the documentation section, declare the name of the program, author of the program, or else details about the program statements. Okay, what we are declaring into this here? In this section, we are declaring the name of the program. Okay, I will show you how you are declaring. Okay, or else you can declare author of the program. Author of the program. Okay. Or else you can perform details about the program statements. Details about the program statements. See, we can mention in the documentation section. Okay, so this section can be declared on the name of the program, author of the program, or else details about the program statements. So whatever you are defining the statements, that statements are defined with the use of some commenting symbols. Yes, we are writing the, so in the documentation section, like suppose you are writing the addition of two numbers program means here. In that here we are placing the, yes, this is a name for the program. Okay, or else author of the program. What is the details of the program? What we are doing into that? That is we are placing that one. Okay, right. So here, this is optional statement. Here documentation section is optional statement. Then if it is working or not into the our programmatic. When you are writing the documentation section into the programmatic, it cannot be executed into the output manner. Okay, it can't execute anything. Whatever you are writing, that cannot be executed. So why? Because here we are placing this one into whatever you are declaring that can be placed into the commenting symbols. So how it will be stores here, whatever you are defining, so that can be stores or that can be stores the our statements into the commenting symbols. Okay, so we have the commenting symbols. How it will be displayed? Okay, whatever it may be, those statements are defined with the use of the some symbols. Those symbols we can call like commenting symbols. What we have the commenting symbols here? We have the comment symbols is will be like this. Commenting symbols will be like this. Okay, so documentation section cannot be executed by the C compiler. Whatever you are writing, that is just for knowing purpose. That is just not your declaring means you are executing the anything into the our C compiler. Just here this documentation section is the knowing purpose. Whatever you are writing the program, okay, how it will be used, that is only declared into the commenting section. It is not executing any statement into the output. Okay, so here documentation section cannot be executed by the our C compiler. This is just for knowing purpose. Yes, we have the commenting symbols. For example, how we will declare these commenting symbols here? Suppose you are writing the simple program. Okay, so you know. Okay, you know that one, and also I know that one. Yes, this is a simple program. Okay, so but here some people cannot understand without the seeing the programming. So in that situations you can write first commenting symbols with the simple program and again close the commenting symbols. Again, close the commenting symbols. Yes, by seeing this simple program, they are understanding. Yes, this is a simple program for the C language. Okay, so or else you see this. Suppose you are writing the addition of two numbers. Okay, so you know that. Okay, you know addition of, this is the program for the addition of two numbers. But other people cannot understand this is the addition of two numbers, right? So that's what you can represent that into addition of two numbers within the comments. These comments, whatever you are writing into the comments, that is just for knowing purpose only. That will not executed by the our C compiler. So this is for only knowing purpose. Okay, so this is the optional also. So if you need, you can write. If you are not writing, there is no problem. Okay, so your documentation section, in this section just here, we are defining the name of the program, or else your other of the program, details about the program statements. These statements are declared into the some symbols. Those symbols we can call like commenting symbols. In that we are placing the whatever you are thinking, whatever you are writing the name of the program. So in that we are placing that. Right here by whatever you are writing, that cannot be executed by the our C compiler. That is just for knowing purpose. Whatever we are writing the program, that is just for knowing purpose. This is the documentation section, and this is just for optional only, right? And next year we have the link section. Next year we have the link section. Link section. Okay, so link section is the mandatory. We can call this is also header section. We can call this is also header section right here. So in this section, the compiler can invokes the header files. We are calling this section is the header section, right? So here our compiler, C compiler, is invoking the, in this, okay, in this linking section, our C compiler is invoking the header files. Okay, it is invoking the header files. Okay, so here in this section, the C compiler can invoke the header files, which are used for the C program. Whatever you are writing the header files, those are used for the program. So program means when you are writing the program, it is useful. This linking section. Without the linking section, we cannot write, we cannot process our programmatic. So this is mandatory. This is very mandatory. So what we have here, what we have the linking sections here. See, for example, we have the linking sections. Hash include stdio.h. Okay, here what is std? Here std means your standard io.h, standard input output dot h. H means your header file. H means your header file. Hash include is the header. Okay, so means your this hash include is taking one type of preprocessors. Okay, right, hash include stdio.h. std means your standard input output dot h. H means your header file, standard input output header file. Okay, so this is, we can call like header file, or else we can call this one is the preprocessors. Okay, right. And next here we have hash include conio.h. conio.h. conio.h means your console input output header file. Console, here con means your console. We can call your stdio.h is the standard input output dot h, and here we can call conio means your console input output. Don't forget these tuple forms, right? And next here we have hash include math.h. Hash include math.h. Your math.h means here when you are performing the difficulty mathematical functions, in that situations you have to be use the math.h. Okay, suppose you are finding the area of rectangle, area of circle, so like this. Okay, so some difficulty programs. Okay, some difficulty programs. When you are making the mathematical programs, you're in that cases you can use the some mathematics math dot h. Again, we have the string dot h. Ash include string dot h. Okay, so in the some situations only we are using the our string dot h. So mostly we are using the ash include stdio dot h and ash include conio dot h. Mostly we are using these two only. Yes, we are using the math and string only, but in the all the situations we are using the first two only. Okay, so your ash means your preprocessor. Hash means your preprocessor. So here I'm writing what is hash and what is like. Okay, hash what means your preprocessor. Okay, and here we have the include. Here what is include means here this is the library function. In the previous classes we got one what is like a library function, right? Here include is the one library function. Include is the one library function. Okay, so this stdio, conio, string, math, these are all the standard library functions for the include. Okay, so your preprocessors, here we have ash is the one preprocessor to process the our header files. To process the our header files, what we have your header files here? What we have your header files? We have the header files is like stdio dot h, conio dot h. Okay, and again we have the math dot h, string dot h. We have the string dot h. Okay, so your ash is the preprocessor to process the our header files. What we have the header files means your stdio dot h, conio dot h, math dot h, and string dot h, right? And this can be performed to our standard library like include. Okay, so this can be performed our standard library include. Okay, so this is the our link section. So in this link section we are performing the our header files with the preprocessors. This is very important. So means here without this here we cannot perform any programming. So means this is the mandatory section. Okay, next here we have the defining section. Next we have the third one, defining section. Third one, defining section. Right, in this section we are declaring the our constant values. Okay, in this section we are declaring the whatever we have, those are declared into this. Okay, so but those are into the constant values only. In the defining section we are declaring the constant values, and those constant values are working entire the program. So there's just they are not used for the only one step, two steps. Okay, so whatever you are writing the constant values, those are working for the entire programming. Entire programming, right? So your these values are declaring with the hash define header file. Okay, whatever you are writing the constant values, those values are defined with the hash defined statement. Hash defined statement. Okay, so in the linking section, okay, whatever you wrote in the linking section, you are declaring directly. So we can change if you need. Okay, so but here whatever you are writing the defining section, that cannot be changeable. That can be always in the constant values, and those constant values are always using for the entire programming only. So here we are using the as defined. For example, okay, we are using the preprocessors with the our library function. This is here define is also one type of library function. Okay, so this define is taking the pi 3.14. Here define is taking the pi value 3.14, pi value. So here pi value is the always constant. It cannot be changeable. This cannot be changeable. Pi value is always 22/7, or else here it is the 3.14. It cannot be changeable. So means here whatever you are writing into the constant defining section, that is definitely constant value. Permanently it cannot be changeable. So for that only you have to be create the our define. Okay, or else here you can take mark section. Okay, you can take the marks. Maximum marks. Here I am taking the 100. Here I am taking the 100. So whatever you are taking the maximum marks, that is definitely 100 only. So means you suppose you have the first subject, you have the 100 marks, means you that is definitely 100. Okay, maximum marks will be 100. Minimum marks will be whatever you are scoring, that is only. Right here, definitely our marks will be 100. And we have another example also for this. Define name. Define name. So your name is always constant. If you are changing yourself, that is changeable only. So but your whatever you have the name, so that is always constant only. Okay, so here I'm writing my name only. Okay, so whatever you're writing, so that name is always constant only. So in the defining section also we are writing the preprocessors with the our library functions. Okay, whatever you're writing, that is always in the constant values only. And next here we have the global declaration section. Next here we have the global declaration section. Global declaration section. Okay, so this global declaration section is used for the data types with the variables, right? So here it is allowing the whatever you are writing the programs and those variables, and those variables are used to in our programming, and that can be works with the throughout the our programming. Okay, whatever you are writing the variables, that can be works in the our throughout the programming, means here from the starting of the initialization of the variables, from the end it is performing the our variables. Okay, so in this global declaration section, just we are using the data types and the variables. Just we are using the data types and the variables. That's it. Here nothing is there for the global declaration section. Okay. And next here we have the main function section. This is the very, very important section. Next we have the main function section. Okay. Next we have the main function section. It is very important. Every C programming, not only C programming, any programmatic. So here we are talking about the C programming, right? So that's what here I am telling you like this. Every C programming must have the main function. Without the main function, we cannot run the programs. Yeah, whatever it may be, when you are writing the programs, when you are starting the programs, definitely you have to be use the main programming. Okay, without the main function, we cannot run, we cannot compile anything, we cannot do the our programming. Okay, without the main programming, we cannot run the program. Okay, and C compiler can be recognized main function first. Okay, we have the compiler, right? So our compiler will recognize the main function first. After that only it is performing everything. Okay, what we have the execution purpose, what we have the any performance, anything will be first declaration of the main function only. Our C compiler can be recognizes the our main function first. After that, here it is starting the execution for the main function. Once here it is recognition that one, so it is again starting to the execution purpose. Okay. And once here, after completion of the main function, here our program is starting with the opening brace. Okay. After the starting of the main function, our program will be starts with the opening brace. and ends with the closing brace. It is starting with the opening brace and it is ends with the closing brace. We can call this one is the opening brace, and we can call this one is the closing brace. Okay, opening and closing braces. Okay, so just here, easy, simple. Okay, so first you can write like this and you can write like this. It is very simple. Okay, so don't write different formats for this. So if you are writing that one, so definitely everyone will be cross that one. So means you have lost the 1 marks, right? So here main function is always starting. So means here without that one we cannot compile any programmatic. Here compiler first reads the our main function only. So once you place out the main function, okay, void main or anything, so it is recognizing the after that it is recognizing the opening brace. Here once you are placing anything into that, after it is closing to the program. Okay, so here once you are opening that brace, here we are doing the declaration part. Here we are writing the declaration part into that. Okay, what we have the declaration part? In this declaration part, we are declaring, or else here every C programming is manipulating the data with the using of the variable declaration. Okay, in the declaration part, you have to be use the variable declaration that can be using the our data types. Here, whatever you are declaring the variables, those variables are defined by the our data types. Okay, so without the variables, you can place the data types is also possible. But without data type, here we cannot write the our variables. Okay, so in this here, in the declaration part, you are placing the variables. Okay, in this declaration part, you are placing the variables, and how we have the variables means here like this, we are writing int a, b, c. Like this, we are writing the our variables. Okay, so when we have the means here, we are talking this is the data type and this is the variables. Okay, so when we have the data types and the variables, I will explain more clearly for this. Okay, right. Okay, declaration part is just for creating for the variables, and in that we are placing the like in the float. Like this here, we have the so many data types, and A to Z is the our variables. Okay, A to Z is the our variables. And next here we have the executable statements. And next here we have the executable statements, or else we can call like executable part. Okay, so in this executable part, here we are calling like in this executable part, at least it is having the only one statement. At least, okay, at least it is having the only one statement into the executable part, and these statements are used to define the data which are manipulated, or else here which are compiled by the our C compiler. Whatever you are declaring, whatever you are executing, so why we are writing the program, so to need to be executed, right? So at least it is needing one executable part. Okay, so without that, here why we need to be right? Okay, so our C compiler, whatever you wrote in the execution part, so that can be manipulates this one. Okay, and here the statements, those are appear into the opening and closing braces. Right here we have opening and closing braces. Whatever you are writing, those are appears in the opening and closing braces, which are executed by the our C compiler. Whatever you are placing, that is executing by the our C compiler. And this declaration part, declaration statements and the execution statements definitely having the semicolons. Without the semicolon, we cannot write anything. So, and here this is, at least it is having the, okay, at least one statement you have to write. At least one statement you have to be placed into this. Okay, so and this declaration part and this execution part is definitely having the semicolon. End of the statement definitely have to be write the semicolon. And next here we have the subprogram. At last we have the subprogram. Your subprogram means your functions we are placing. So this is optional only. Okay, and this programming, the sub program section is having the all the user defined functions only. We can call this is the main function. Okay, so means here the sub program section contains all the user defined functions that are called in the main function. Whatever you are writing the sub program, okay, whatever you are writing the functions into the sub program, so those functions are calling to the our main function. Whatever you wrote the main function, that can be called into this. Okay, and user defined functions are generally placed immediately after the main functions. Okay, if you are declaring these subprogramming functions, after the main function only have to be declare this one. Without the declaration for the main function, we cannot place the our subprograms into this. Okay. Okay, so your subprogram is always comes to after main programming. Okay, declaration will be done after main programming. After main program means your main function. After main function only have to be declared this one. Then see the one simple program for this. Here I am writing the one simple program, or else here one example program for this. Here we have totally documentation section, link section, defining section. Okay, see this here. Once here we have the documentation section, link section, defining section, global declaration section, and main function. In that we have the declaration part and the execution part. And again at last we have the sub program. That sub program is defined after the main function section only. So in that also we are placing the user defined functions. Just see the simple program, we'll understand how you are writing this structure by using this structure. Okay, first here I'm writing the documentation section. Okay, right here I'm writing the one simple program, or else you can write the first program also. Here I'm writing the simple program. So this is the documentation section. This is the documentation section. And next here I am writing the link section. So defined section is also not in all cases we are not using. So in some situations only we are using the defining section also. So next here I am writing the link section. Okay. Ash include. So this is just your knowing purpose. This is not mandatory in when you are writing the programs. Okay. So just for knowing purpose. Ash include. Here I will start the our program. stdio.h ash include. conio.h ash include. stdio.h ash include. conio.h. Okay, so here after that you can place the our global declaration section, right? So but global declaration section is having the variables. Okay, I will consider, but here we are not writing the global declaration in this example. When we have the global declaration example, I will explain in that here. Okay, so just here we are placing the local only. Okay, so here directly I am taking the void function. Main function here I am taking. Directly here I am taking the main function without the declaring that. Okay. Void main. Void is the return type here. Void is the return type. And main is the our function. After the main function you have to be open the our opening brace. Okay. So here void is the return type. Here I will write what is void means here. Return type. What is void means here? I am writing here return type. Void is the return type. And main is the one function. After the declaring that you have to be open the brace. And here I am writing the CLR SCR. Okay, CLR SCR means your clear the screen. Whatever you wrote in the previous, we will get the output in the our command prompt. So once you are writing the clear screen, it will be clears the our command prompt in the clear format. Okay, whatever you are writing, that is only showing. Okay, clear screen. And next here we have the printf. Okay, so this is our executable path here. I am writing hello world. In the printf, I am giving the hello world. Okay, so this executable part and declaration part is always having the always having the semicolons, right? End of the statement you have to give the semicolon, and after that here you have to be give the get ch. It is reading the our whatever you given the statements, it is reading that one. Okay, get character, see, means you get character. Okay, and close this one, and close this one. It is giving the our output PLV like this, hello world. Here it is giving the our output will be like this, hello world. This is a simple program, whatever your listened basic structure. So by that basic structure only here we are writing. So in the further cases we will get the not simple programming, we will get the whatever your listening the classes for the topic only we are getting the programs. Okay, so this is just a simple programming. Okay, so we'll discuss more about in the next classes.